This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to use the Maui Meta tool. Now this tool, just like SNWrite tool, helps you write IMEI to your MTK Android phone. Now for you to use this tool, you need to have your Mediatek USB VCOM drivers installed on your PC. I have the folder here and I'll be explaining how to install these drivers. And you need to also have the MD1DB file for the particular phone model which are trying to write IMEI to. Now you can get this file from the firmware for that particular phone model, so just check the Hovatek forum for the firmware for your phone model and you can get the MD1DB file from the firmware folder. Now for the VCOM drivers, I will briefly take you through the installation of these drivers. Now if you are using a Windows 8 or 10 PC, ensure to disable your signature verification before you proceed with installing these drivers. The reason is that these VCOM drivers are not signed, so if you don't disable your signature verification on Windows 8 or 10, you are going to have an error, so ensure you do that. Now for you to do that, just check the Hovatek forum for the guide on how to disable signature verification on a Windows 8 or 10 PC and you follow that to disable that check for your Windows 8 or 10. Now for Windows 7 you don't need to do that, alright, because that is not enabled by default. Now for the MAUI Meta, you need to install it like a regular software. It's not like you just extract the zip and just run. You need to extract from the folder, you install like a regular software and then you launch. And it's usually be installed in your program files folder. There you should see an MAUI Meta folder. Alright, so I will not be going through the installation process. I'll just presume you know how to install the software on your PC. So once you install that, you have a shortcut, or you just go to the program files folder. Alright, that's where you launch MAUI Meta. So before I launch MAUI Meta, I'm going to install VCOM drivers, as I earlier said. So to do that, you're going to press the window button or the start menu and you search for device manager. All right okay, and then launch device manager. Now in device manager, you don't want to click just any item on the list, anyone at all, so just click on batteries, then you click on action, add legacy hardware, next, install the hardware that I manually select from a list, next, have disk, browse. Now you navigate to the location of the Mediatek VCOM drivers. These are my drivers here. Alright, so you just open the Mediatek USB VCOM drivers, you open the drivers folder, you select USB VCOM driver. Now if you are using a Windows 7, 8 or 10 PC, you select this Windows 7 folder, but for Vista and XP, select appropriately. So I'm using a Windows 8 PC, so I open the Windows 7 folder. Now I'm select between 32 and 64 bits, and my PC is a 64 bit PC, so I will select this. So if you do not know what kind of architecture your PC uses, you just come down to my computer, right click here, properties, and yeah, you see that here, 64 bit. Alright, so you can check yours. So mine is a 64 bit PC. I select this. If yours is 32, you select this. I'm 64, so I go for this. I click on open and then OK. Now this driver is not digitally signed. You can see that error. Next. It doesn't mean it won't work, so don't panic. Just a warning. Next. Alright, the following hardware was installed, Mediatek USB VCOM port. Now if you get a prompt before this particular screen asking you to confirm installation of the driver, you go ahead to install. It is just Windows trying to protect you from installing an unsigned driver. It doesn't mean it's not going to work, they just feel it's not secure since it's not signed, so just go ahead. Alright, so I click on finish. Now to confirm my drivers have been installed, I just scroll down. Now I can see my MediaTek drivers listed here. Now don't be alarmed by these yellow triangles. This is just Windows indicating that you've installed an unsigned driver and it's possible it malfunctions. It doesn't mean it's not going to work. It's just a standard warning, you know, making you know if you installed an unsigned driver and you might encounter some errors. But I assure you, you will not encounter any errors if you have installed the way I have instructed it to install. Alright, so this is nothing to panic about. Alright, so I'm done installing my MediaTek VCOM drivers. I will go ahead and launch my MAUI Meta as administrator. I prefer to run as admin to avoid permission issues, but if I know an admin on the PC, just double click, just run as regular user, but I prefer to run as admin. Alright, yes, so I have this up. Now at this point you'd want to switch off the phone, but don't connect it to the PC yet. Just switch off the phone, still with the battery inside, but do not connect it to the PC yet. Now you'd want to take a look, observe this. This is red, as you can see. This is indicating that there's no connection at all. And under this tab, you want to select the appropriate option for your phone. I'm using a smartphone, so I have smartphone ticked. No other settings to change. I'm going to leave this as USB COM. So there's nothing to change on this dashboard. All right. So I click on reconnect. Now at this point you see this changing from red to green. So what you'd want to do now is to, with the phone switched off and with battery inside, you connect it to the PC via USB cord without holding any button on the phone. Just connect without holding any button on the phone. Alright. So you'd observe that your phone would come up. A phone will boot up and it will get stuck at the boot animation. Alright, so what I have here is a charging sign and I have to reconnect. Alright, I'm going to reconnect. Yes, so I've reconnected and it's no more the charging sign. Now I'm seeing my boot animation right now. So if you see the charging sign the first time you connect, you disconnect and reconnect. So your phone is going to boot up and it's going to get stuck at the charging and at the boot animation. So do not panic. That is your phone in Meta mode. All right. Do not panic. It's not bricked. All right. So my phone is stuck at boot animation and I have this prompt here. What I see here is barcode, but I'm not trying to write a barcode to my phone, so I will just close this. Alright, so I have a yellow circle here indicating that it has been connected. Good, and phone information is displayed here. So what I want to write is an IMEI to the phone, so I will just click on this drop down at the top left corner and then select IMEI download. Now it's illegal to change your IMEI in certain countries, if not all countries, so ensure you're not breaking any laws by writing an IMEI to your phone. All right, so once the IMEI download dashboard has popped up, what you'd want to do now is to click on Change NVRAM Database File. It's at this point you are going to load the md1_db file I mentioned earlier on. So you click on Change NVRAM Database File. Now a window will pop up. Yes, in this window you now navigate to the location where you have the MD1DB file and you select it. Now it will usually be named something like this: BPLGUI Info Custom App, you know, something like this. It's going to be named something like this. All right. This is an APDB. This is not the file you need. Although you'd need this one using SNWrite too, but for MAUI Meta, you need just this file. All right, so you highlight this file and you click on open. You highlight and you click on open. This is dragging for some reason. I guess it's just all right. Okay, so you'd notice I have the file path listed here. It's written here, so that means it's correctly loaded. I also have checksum here. I have this. So at this point, you load the database file, the DB file. So you'd want to select either your SIM 1 or 2, depending on which you want to write the IMEI to. I will just select SIM 1, and then you write, you select, you type in the IMEI. Now you'd notice that you have just enough space for 14 digits here. So you're going to type the first 14 digits of the IMEI. Alright, so automatically generates the last digit for you. So with IMEI inserted and my SIM selected, I go ahead to click on download to flash. Alright, so I have this message saying download IMEI to flash successfully. Alright, so what I just need to do now is to disconnect the phone and then hold the power button till it goes off and then reboot it. Or if the battery is removable, just take out the battery and then you reinsert it. Then you dial *#06# to check your IMEI, and you should see that the IMEI has been successfully written to the phone. So that's basically how to use MAUI Meta tool.